Could Viagra be the unexpected key to unlocking your gains? A study by clinical and translational science suggests it might be, going so far as to compare this little blue pill to a testosterone injection. But what does all the research say? And why is this watermelon so crucial in exploring Viagra's muscle-building potential?
Good watermelon.
The study I just showed found that Viagra helped subjects to increase their leg extension repetitions substantially more than the placebo group. The Viagra group basically did about 140% more reps as opposed to 80%. Unfortunately, the researchers didn't measure the difference in actual muscle growth. But since increases in performance do strongly correlate with extra muscle, there's a good chance the Viagra group was in fact able to put on more size. On top of that, the scientists also found that the approximate doubling of skeletal muscle protein synthesis observed in response to sildenafil, which is Viagra, is of similar magnitude to that observed in response to a 100 to 200 mg per week testosterone injection. The increase in muscle protein synthesis from Viagra was basically double that of the placebo group, and muscle protein synthesis is a required process to build muscle. However, there are a couple of things to consider. The people taking Viagra were on average 55 years old and overweight. And medications that have an effect in certain risk groups don't necessarily have the same effect on jacked lifters like you. You smart, handsome, sexy fella. And then there's a comparison to testosterone. Yes, Viagra does seem to increase muscle protein synthesis as much as testosterone in the short term, but testosterone keeps muscle protein synthesis elevated for a longer period of time. Secondly, just eating some protein also raises protein synthesis, meaning Viagra isn't nearly as special as they make it sound to be. The increase in performance, however, is remarkable, but isn't hard evidence because it's only one study. And let's be honest, the placebo effect could have probably played a role. It's probably very hard to not notice you're taking Viagra. One other study tries to look at the potential mechanisms behind the supposed increase in performance. They found that Viagra was indeed able to increase blood flow, which might help do a few more repetitions. However, unfortunately, this benefit only seems to be applicable to elderly and not healthy young men. But mechanistic studies aren't the most reliable. So I found it very hard to give up my hope on Viagra. I just wasn't finished yet. So I started looking at more and more studies, until finally I landed on our watermelon. But first I need to quickly explain how Viagra works. Viagra is like a key for opening a door in your body, disabling the lock on the door, which is the enzyme PDE5. This door is blocking the production of nitric oxide. But once you open this door, nitric oxide starts rushing in. This nitric oxide causes the veins in your body to relax and expand, allowing blood to move more freely. It's like a floodgate opening up, giving you the surge of blood needed for an erection. Similarly, increased blood flow to your muscles would be like opening up the floodgates for them, possibly providing them with more oxygen and energy for a bigger pump and increased performance. However, there are again a few tricky things to consider. Viagra works on the PDE5 doors, but these are mostly found in your dick, not your muscles. But it might possibly still have a significant effect on the very small amount of PDE5 doors located around your muscles. Now, what's so special about this watermelon? There is one supplement that basically provides fuel to a generator that starts producing nitric oxide. So instead of unlocking the door, it's working on a different pathway. Viagra increases nitric oxide by inhibiting PDE5, but this supplement does it by converting into arginine, which then starts making nitric oxide. So both do increase nitric oxide contents in the body to increase blood flow. However, the big difference here is that instead of mostly increasing nitric oxide near the penis like Viagra, the supplement increases it all over the body. But this allows us to look at the studies on this supplement and very loosely relate them to Viagra, because they do work on different pathways. The supplement I'm talking about is citrulline, which comes from the Latin word for watermelon, citrullus. And according to this meta-analysis, it does significantly increase the number of repetitions you can do for an exercise, which would theoretically lead to more muscle growth. In these studies, the average age was 25, so much more applicable to you. Citrulline might help you do a few extra reps, but not to a large degree. The increase in performance is much less noticeable than, for example, taking creatine, so I do think that Viagra has some extra muscle building effects, but they're probably going to be very minimal, especially if you're young and healthy. If you're still looking to get those benefits, I recommend taking citrulline instead. Viagra is a synthetic drug, meaning it has a very strong effect on your body and comes with a lot more side effects. Citrulline, on the other hand, is naturally found in your food. On top of that, the effect of Viagra is most likely centered around the genital area and not near the muscles. Now, if you want to learn how you might be missing out on 50% more gains, you might want to watch this video next, because I learned that the mind-muscle connection is overrated and might cause you to leave some gains on the table. Right?